Movies don't just show us how the world is, they show us how the world can be. And if we change the way that movies are made, I think you can change the world.
I think you and I want the same thing. See, I want to take the story of Hollywood and give it a rewrite.
This is exactly what this studio needs right now. Something no one saw coming, something new, something fresh.
Repellent subject matter, anti-national feeling, and then they're gonna throw us out of every movie theater in the South for a generation.
Son of a bitch!
I think that there is a very powerful theme in the series of you feel marginalized, that your story is valuable.
Telling a story about fractured people in a gorgeous setting.
Camille Washington.
Exploring how those people try to tell their stories within the rules that a certain time period would only allow so much of.
I'm gonna be an actor, see, so I can't have anybody thinking I'm that way.
Instead of writing about the seedy underbelly of Hollywood in the 40s, the show is then able to turn into something that is about the Hollywood and the America that could have been.
You're colored. I love it.
I think that this show is really amazing because it highlights the struggles of all marginalized people throughout history through the lens of Hollywood.
Do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Everybody's sort of a prisoner of the context that this time has given them.
We need to replace you.
Archie Coleman, played by Jeremy Pope, is a screenwriter. He's a black man who is out and gay. He's very progressive and ahead of his time in that way, but in the studio system at this time, there were no black writers, there were no out writers at that time period, and definitely none who were black and out. And so I think for Archie, it's constantly trying to figure out ways to get credit for his work.
I wrote Peg to prove my writing was not limited by my race.
While also figuring out a way to show up fully.
Me, every time I step out my door, I start lying to the world. It's weighing on me. I ain't gonna do it no more.
Archie is so confident. That's a very bold thing to say, especially in the 40s, where, again, you know, trying to occupy a space in an industry that isn't really catering to you.
You go out and you live your life with your head held high.
Coffee, Miss Delilah?
Camille, when she's forced to play a maid, looking at Hattie McDaniel, she was this incredible actress. She won an Academy Award, but she was marginalized and always had to play a maid.
Hattie McDaniel was the first black performer to win the Academy Award for her work in Gone with the Wind.
I've been through it, Hollywood. So if you need anything, darling, just ask me, all right?
Yes, ma'am.
What Hattie represents at that time period, specifically for Camille Washington, is the first black woman to do it. But she had to do it within the confines of playing stereotypes.
It was a weird twist that her career sort of didn't really go anywhere. Even after winning the Oscar, it was almost like they'd given her an Oscar and said, like, okay, now go away.
What we wanted to do was to give Hattie a different kind of happy ending. Her happy ending is to see another black actress not only be cast as the romantic lead and not playing the domestic, but also gripping that Academy Award to really show that her legacy lived on.
You scream, you shout, you scratch somebody's eyes out if you have to, but you demand the respect that you owe.
I'm gonna change the way they make movies in this town. I'm gonna make sure that people like us aren't on the outside looking in anymore.
I love this character detail that speaks to Darren Criss, and it speaks to the character of Raymond, that he is Hapa, that he's half Asian, and that the fact that he can pass. And I just thought that, oh, that's so great that that was in there.
I was ashamed of who I was, but I'm tired of playing it safe. I want to be different, I want to be who I am, and I want to start taking risks.
What he's doing is he's wanting to say, I'm embracing this part of myself, and I want race to be something that we bring other people into the spotlight.
A lot of the ideas that Raymond has are quite revolutionary and pretty renegade.
This town will never give that to someone like me.
I'm going to change that.
He wants to revive the career of one Anna Mae Wong, who, you know, was the first Chinese American, Asian American, bona fide movie star.
The Good Earth, Anna Mae Wong, screen test, take one.
The role of a lifetime was written for her, and she had the notoriously one of the best screen tests in history and couldn't get cast because of the Hays Code.
And the Academy Award goes to
Louise Ryder for the good earth.
She was denied a role that was meant for an Asian woman, and it went to a white woman, and that was a huge tragic turning point in her career.
And action.
She was a star, but it was always mixed with this a sense of injustice or denial that she wasn't able to have the career that she deserved. So it was very meaningful to see what it would look like if that story had played out differently.
These characters have struggled so hard.
I barely got my foot in the door. You asking me to help you? Choose you? Well, ain't nobody ever chosen me, Jack.
What Ryan did so beautifully is we take a turn. We say, what if we would have done this and given people opportunities? How exciting and beautiful it could have been or could be.
With just a few brave people making that one brave choice to do something different, what kind of change you can enact, and how different our world would look now if this had happened in 1947 instead of 1997.
They let me in alone this time.
The happy endings that happen, what we like to call our happy beginnings, really allow us to think about the problems that we still have today within the industry.
The show is a beautiful what if, and what you hope people come away with is more of a why not? Why couldn't this have happened? And why can't it happen more now?
We create a fantasy in Hollywood in the 40s where you can be black and be the lead actress or actor or screenwriter.
I'm showing up to the Oscars with him, on my arm.
You can be gay, you can be open about it. You can want something and achieve it.
I was fighting their fight, but now it's time to fight ours.
We kind of watched that throughout the season.
Are we doing the right thing?
Absolutely we are.
These, you know, forks in the road of which way are you gonna go? Which side of history are you gonna fall on?
The series is that kind of spotlight on where we should go.
Thank you all so much.
And what inclusivity truly looks like.
This picture is just the beginning for this studio. Equality. Progress. That's what we should stand for.